The first concept that I want to discuss is about the difference between structured data and unstructured data. Well, what is structured data? You probably used Excel. Then you know the concept of a spreadsheet, yes? When we have a spreadsheet, what we have? We have columns with very clear data. We know what are the data that are in the rows, in the cells. And for example, the first one here, sex. We can have two different data in this case here, female and male. And also age, for example. We know that for a client in a bank, the age, the value should be between maybe 18, 20, to close to the 100. All the numbers outside this, you probably will recognize that they're not great, but you know exactly what are the data below all of these columns. Yes, email, there must be a correct email, phone number, you know usually how many numbers compound of a phone number, and things like that. Another example, this table here, loans, yes? You have here account ID. Usually there's a rule how you build the account IDs, and you know what exactly you expect here. You know, for example, status in this case, probably the data will be A, B, C or something like that. You know exactly what is the structure. Previously, before you start to use that data, that you have a concept, you have a schema, how this data were being stored. And, for example, you can even make connections, relationship between more than one data using this kind of keys, primary keys, account ID, client ID, and connect and correlate data from one table to data from the other table. This is very common. Everybody which use, for example, Excel, understand what is structured data. But what is the opposite of structured data? Is unstructured data. And what kind of data we are talking about? We are talking about text, free text. We are talking about images. We are talking about sounds, sounds that could be created by person like me. I'm talking, you are listening to me. This is a sound, but could also be music, for example. And we are talking about videos. That is a mixture between images in motion and sounds and things like that. All of these kinds of data, we said that they are unstructured data. And let me explain why unstructured. Consider this table here. We have one of the fields is a review. But what is inside the review? It's a free text. It's a bunch of words that complete a sentence, for example, but no previous structure inside this free text. Maybe could be write it in capital letters, maybe could use special characters. We don't need previously, we don't know, because this is free. The data is free. And we don't have a structure before we start to really look at the data. Another example, a tweet. For example, this tweet here from Bill Gates. We cannot assure what is a structure before Bill Gates start to write this tweet here. We don't know exactly. Could be only text, could be a mix of text plus URLs, links, and connections to videos. It's very unstructured format, and we have to deal with this. Another example here, a document, for example, a document with text, maybe in some kind of structure, columns, but inside the columns, we don't know exactly what kind of structure is there. It's text, could be in capital letters, could be in bold letters, but it's just text and we don't know previously. And in this kind of document, for example, we have text, but we also have images. Images, again, are another kind of unstructured data. And let's see about images. What we can see about image. Compare all this image. Quickly, you can see that we are talking about cats here. But the image are completely different. Someone are smaller, someone are larger, someone has a better quality, some others not, then okay, again, there's no previous structure before you take a picture. We do not know exactly what we can't, yes, for sure, create a structure, because pixel digital images are converted in pixels, and pixels are numbers that can represent the intensity of, for example, a color. And we have three different channels: red, green and blue channels, RGB. We receive different numbers, but could be pictures, as I said, from different sizes, from different grayscale color pictures, grayscale pictures. The one below in this chart here is a grayscale picture, and at the end we will convert this to a structure, a matrix of numbers. But previously, no one knows exactly what is the format, what will be, what are the objects that I will put in the next picture I will take. There's no previous information about this. And even sounds. I'm talking here. I'm creating sounds with different tones, with different volumes below. There's no previous structure in this kind of data. Sounds at the end will be converted in bits to be stored and managed after that. But we do not define what will be the format, the structure of the data. And the same with videos. And videos is so complex because we have images in motion and we have sounds, everything combined together in just one file. And this is completely unstructured in terms of the content that are in there. We know there are some structures, yes, to create the video files, but the content that will there, no structure to that. And this is completely different when we compare with spreadsheets that we know exactly that in that cell, for example, is a date, and that's in another cell will be some currency in dollars, Canadian dollars, US dollars. You can put some formats before you use that data. And that's the reason why deal with structured data is one kind of work. But when you have to deal with unstructured data, text, videos, sounds, images, it's another way how to deal with this kind of data.